happy, Larry. Could not be happier. Could not be happier.
In a large housing scheme in Kilmarnock, more than 1,000 families live in a mix of privately owned and council houses. Just a few of those households agreed to be filmed over the course of a year. The scheme follows the stories of 6 different families, looking at the ups...
A cheque for 500.
..and downs of life.
Being a fuck-off, man, I'm not gonna...
Showing people trying to do their bit for the community.
Once we get inside, the hound will come back out. It's a sitting.
As well as those who are simply struggling to hold their families together.
They would sell the full house. They'd be wanting the cash generated every day. I'm playing to drink, Charlie.
Last time in the scheme, ex-heavy drinkers and hellraisers, Gordon and Annie, were desperate to keep their kids on the straight and narrow.
Don't start shouting at me. You're no steiner.
Aye, all right.
But their eldest son was jailed after a long list of charges finally caught up with him.
He got 8 months.
He got him the full whack.
Their youngest son, Chris, was also in trouble with some local drug dealers.
He can't sort of look for me, man, just there about here. Fuck him up.
To make matters worse, Gordon was out of work. But after 2 months of looking, he's finally managed to get his first job interview.
You bit nervy, you know? It's the suit, it's because I'm wearing the suit usually, and I'm wearing the suit and got to court. They call me the accused.
You've got to tell them that he's got a week's holiday in June. He went for an interview before and he was going on holiday and then he never heard back from them.
I hate being out of work. It's because of this recession and it's, you're talking about, don't know many folks going for the one job.
In the scheme last time, ex-heroin addict Marvin was inseparable from his much-loved dog, Bullet.
He just loves getting kisses and cuddles through this.
Marvin was looking for love and got together with ex-girlfriend, 18-year-old Dana, after she was released from prison on an electronic tag.
Happy, Larry. Could not be happier.
Despite Dana thinking she was pregnant, Marvin strayed back into taking drugs, and he and Dana began to argue. And after a bust up on a bus, he ended up in jail for the weekend.
He need me in the stomach, but I don't think he meant it.
While Marvin has been cooling off in the cells, there have been rumours circulating that Dana has slept with Gordon and Annie's son, Chris.
I went in drunk, not me, gone to a more bang, heard that. I took my trips down, cutting my trips down and that. John that went down, man, him, I know, we rap, mate. He was doing me down, he getting there, I know.
Marvin's family don't trust Dana and have told him about the rumours. But Dana is adamant that her honour remains intact.
Christopher was in here and left and went out along to Cairns, drunk, and said,
No, he walked out like that.
I just shagged Marvin's bird. Right, and he swore in Cairns' kid's life. And then, see, after it, he admitted the truth that he hadn't. So Christopher's finito with me. So yeah, he's finished. I'm finished with them all.
That's
us. They told me I was to make a choice, so I made my choice. That's me, I'm not speaking to my mum.
We've spoken fake out and I love it again.
That's us. We're getting engaged. We're actually engaged in it, but I've not got a ring yet.
He swore that he's picked me out of the Valium and we've sorted the shit out. He swore
I picked it out of my family.
Owen everything that he would never, ever, ever lift a horn to me again.
Gordon has a job interview at a local factory and has arrived in time to calm his nerves with a quick cigarette.
It's
starting to get nervous now. I need a job. Just made me lazy. No working. He ain't no working. 20 past. I better go.
Gordon has always worked since he and Annie gave up serious drinking.
You couldn't meet anybody any nicer if you stopped drinking. It's like chalk and cheese. I don't really think that I could live without him now. Sitting in my sister's one night, my sister who's blind, and the bathers was drinking, and it was a daft argument, started or something. My sister was in the middle, so he lifted this. It was wee bottles, a glass bottle of drink we had. Started to smash one off of my head, so I lifted one and smashed off his head. He lifted one and smashed off my head. My sister's got this glass on her, and the two has put bottle for bottle on one another's head. Like, smashed them. Her house was covered in glass. It was unreal. When I think back to the things that happened when we were drinking, it's funny now, but it wasn't funny at the time.
Back in the scheme, one of Marvin's cousins has moved in next door and is having a housewarming celebration.
You still taking my gorgeous body in? Me, I'm a pole dancer. If any's one shot of me, £10 to go.
Having Marvin's cousin move next door is bad news for Dana, as Marvin's family are convinced that she's cheated on him and don't like her.
I don't know, I'm not too.
I'm not a joke.
Can you?
I'm not a joke.
I know.
It's not long before Marvin's cousin is trying to pick a fight.
Who have I grass then?
Have I grass what?
Who have I grass then?
Look at the little ones. You all got a punch on the food.
I'll see a break before.
Dana needs to stay out of trouble as she's tagged and on early release from prison. And Marvin's not there to defend her.
I'm going to be myself because I know you're out of back and I walked away. It's just not me.
Sorry. You've got to be rough and sorry. Tough to stay about this area because see if you know people tramp at you and if you get tramped there then people just take off. People take advantage of you.
Can I wait to Friday for like this tag off and I'll show every single one of them that I'm not a dafty. Oh.
Me see if somebody speaks to you the wrong way, you can't help it. Staying there running about these
no,
areas.
No, I didn't help, no. See, she talks to you like a clown.
You've got to.
You've got to. Like one. That's where she got. She's looking at her punched her harder.
Gordon's back from his interview for the job in a factory.
I think it went all right. She's fake on man herself, that woman.
That's
true. She's dead man, guys.
Unfortunately, the woman interviewing Gordon is originally from the scheme, lived on their old road, and may even have known them in their former drunken, hell-raising lives.
We were in on Thank Drive for years too, but that's where all the carry-on happened. That's where we drank a lot, in on Thank Drive.
She stayed there she was 12 years old, and she's a lot younger than me, so obviously she's been there and we stayed there, you know what I mean?
Marvin is back from shopping. His cousin is insisting that Dana started the argument. It's all too much for Bullock.
Anybody
but the tag comes out on Friday, I get my results on Friday.
Oh, she went.
What?
Marvin isn't sure who to believe, but Dana wants him to defend her honour.
You've let me stand in there with them all, and you don't do that. No, but when it comes between me and you, you hang it with me. You fight and all that.
She's the fucking right knowing me to see ya.
But no, you don't stick up for your woman, do you know?
I just said stop shouting! Dana, fuck off, man. I'm not
going to... You can better fuck with me, but when it comes to people out there that I'm standing at this, they're saying shit to me, like, boys his own age, he'll not go out and face them. He's what, he can only hit women.
Marvin's still not sure what to believe, and decides that finding Bullet is his top priority.
His own family might get in the night, so I can, I'll probably get an ear kicking off on the night. I just can't help me anymore.
Last time in the scheme, single mum of two, Kay, decided to take in some of her eldest daughter's friends as they were struggling with addictions or were homeless.
I've not had an easy upbringing and I know what it's like. Do you know what I mean? And I just couldn't turn folk away because it's a cry for help for them.
I love her to bits. She's brilliant. She would do anything for Emdy. She would.
Things backfired for Kay as the police were constantly called to the house and her family were dragged into police investigations.
She's getting the blame of that. I wasn't even in the car, I was away. That's how I got out of the car and ran away.
Kay's 15-year-old daughter, Candice, started going out with Gordon and Annie's 20-year-old son, Chris. Her car was smashed up when Chris turned up drunk at 2 in the morning and she wouldn't let him in.
Glass everywhere and butt fast oil and water.
Story's gonna be that I want to go where folk know, that's just stupid.
Kay's friends were telling her to stop helping people, as her house was getting a bad reputation for noise from constant partying. 3 weeks on, things have now escalated, and Kay has been arrested.
My mummy said, don't put me in handcuffs. And the police put her in handcuffs, and my mum had to take her clothes off.
Now I got to sleep till about 6 o'clock.
Lisa, Candice and Jenna have been partying late into the night with loads of their friends.
Because Candice and Jenna's got a lot of pals in and all the rest of it, making a lot of noise. But they're teenagers. My next door neighbour was complaining, had the tune-up, nitpicking all the time. She was bringing her wheelie bin in and I went out to talk to her and I says, look, I'm sorry, where did you get the guy for the tune-up for and all that? And she was just pure cheeky and just spoke to me like a piece of shit, more or less, and I just attacked her.
She was banging her head off the wall and all that.
She was punching me.
She blacked out. She can't remember what she'd done. Oh man.
I just seen red and after that I realised, shit, what have I done? So the police come up and turned my way and charged me. Serious assault, we'd better let him out in bail. So I'm back on the 17th of May.
Kay may be regretting attacking her neighbour, but remains determined not to give up on Jenna and Lisa. Back at Gordon and Annie's, Gordon hasn't heard anything about the job.
I wouldn't panic because the woman says either Monday or Tuesday.
I might just phone Bright Work this afternoon and ask them how my application went. Well, you don't ask, you don't get. That'll show that I'm interested, keen.
He's gonna phone his wee job, see if he's got the job to bring in money.
give me a job.
Is that Braywatts? It's Gordon Cunningham. No. Okay, right, bye. She's been phoning folk today, telling them that I'm not successful, and I've not had a phone call, so that's been good.
Then maybe be lucky enough and get the job then.
Hopefully. I need to say a wee prayers tonight and a wee Hail Mary, isn't it?
You're giving a good Catholic.
Not a bad Catholic.
It's the day of Kay's court case. But she has another problem, as Kendall has been talking about family life at school.
I'm in trouble by messing. Good. The call is the police.
She's telling the police now that's been here, so they've actually seen her. And they're taking it further. I don't know, but she actually said I'm not going to see the teacher today, after the court.
Do
so I need to hurry up and get in a bath.
Kendall is growing up fast, with so many people constantly in the house.
Have you ever looked at them? Candace was attending to Jared. These were buns.
After getting over her car being smashed up, Kay is letting Chris stay over in the house with Candace. Chris has changed his tune and is now saying he lied about sleeping with Dana.
Get a life, I'm going to smash her, you done.
But did you not have a wee thing with her?
No.
What happened between you and Dana, Chris?
Fuck off, man. She's trying to get about me, I thought they both. Talk the fuck off.
It's a pure lie.
They were? But he was drunk.
So he was an excuse, innit?
You were drunk and she took advantage of you, didn't she?
Fuck knows, I can't remember.
Can't remember. Look at his face going red.
Go, Redder. Go, Redder.
Right, Mon. I'm alright. I know it's just a fine or something, I'll get. Hopefully.
Despite the serious nature of the assault charge, Kay is hopeful she will avoid a prison sentence. Gordon and Annie are desperate to keep their youngest daughter on the straight and narrow. Kimberly has been dancing competitively for years, and today she has a major competition where a good result would see her achieve the grade of dance champion.
Got to make yourself brown to make your costume look nicer on you. This is the first I've done mine tan in about 3 years.
Kimberly wins today, that's our last place up to champ if there's enough in a section. So it'll be really hard today, so she'll need to dance a wee bum off.
With a full dance floor, competition is fierce. Kimberly hasn't done her best, as she's been knocked off her stride by an accidental hit in the face.
I get punched in the nose.
She'll wait till she sees if she gets back into the next tee. It could be a semi.
Luckily, Kimberly has a second chance, as she's also entered the pairs competition. At court, Kay is waiting for her assault charge to be heard. She still can't believe the situation with her neighbour got so out of control.
I've never had any bother with her at all. I used to go and get just... Yeah. Candace is a teenager now. Kind of it's like bringing up teenagers with our pals at the door and all the rest of it. And it's just started for that. She's no like to pals and all that coming. She's allowed somebody in a pal or something, but just because there's hundreds of them, a gang of them. It's no easy bringing up a 15-year-old.
Marvin has a court case hanging over him for dealing diazepam in the scheme.
Okay, that's me. Do it then.
It now transpires that Dana's pregnancy was a false alarm, and she's out with friends, leaving Marvin alone to pack in case he gets a jail sentence at tomorrow's trial.
I've got my pictures here. My photographs of Bullet Park to take me. I mean, I've not got a photograph of Dana. That's what she was saying last night. Where's the pictures of me? Actually, I've been thinking about splitting up with her before I go, but I don't know. I don't know what way to tell her.
Why?
Because I just can't be bothered with her. I think I've made a blunder going with somebody as young. So I do.
And where is she right now?
Rubby away, pals drinking. On a Monday afternoon, you know what I mean? See, if she wants the bathroom, she wants to live the grown-up life but still wants to run about. So she's got to, she'll need to make her mind up. But I don't know what words to put into her if we're taking it the wrong way. See, I'm not what to say to her in case she takes it the wrong way, and I'm not what to hurt her upset her.
Under 16 champ.
Back at the dance competition in the doubles, Kimberly has one more chance to win silverware. There's no contact this time, apart from accidentally hitting one of the judges. Kimberly's left to hope her little slip doesn't cost her any points. Kay's assault case has been heard and sentence passed.
6 months good behaviour. So I need to behave for 6 months.
It was like it was my name. A 15-year-old daughter this, a 15-year-old daughter that. It was as if I was to blame, wasn't it?
Good.
You know how the noise and all that. And that's what built up to not getting on with and all that. And they just kept saying a 15-year-old daughter. As if I was sitting there with a pure red face.
But it did start with all your pals coming to the door and all that. That's what it started
with. But it did stop.
Aye.
That is how
aye.
She didn't start not getting on with.
Kay is treading on thin ice. She can't afford to be in any more trouble, and she now has to deal with the appointment at Kendall's school. Back at the dance competition, judging is over and it's the moment of truth for the pairs. Second time lucky, and Kimberly has won gold. Back in the scheme, Kay has been to her youngest daughter's school, where the teachers are checking about changes they're seeing in Kendall's behaviour.
The head teacher wanted to see me, so I went down to see her, and she was asking me what's going on with Kendall and all the rest of it, the pool is here and all the rest of it. And Kendall Hood says to his teacher that she would get taken away in an ambulance at the weekend. Got rushed to hospital, she was in all weekend. But I said she was with her gran all weekend. So she's telling stories.
She's telling lies.
Saying that Kendall's off her tire looking and all the rest. I says, Kendall's fine. She's just making up all these stories.
She just listens too much to adult talk. That's what it is.
She does?
Aye, she does. She's got a wee wild imagination. Runs wild.
Just need to have a wee word with her when she comes home. Tell her to stop talking rubbish.
Despite the school's concerns, the court case and her friend's warnings, Kay is determined that she can cope with the stresses of taking people in who need a helping hand. One of the biggest and well-known families in the scheme are the Crees. For two generations, the whole family have volunteered and helped run activities in the community centre after their parents got it up and running 40 years ago.
We started an adult club, a youth club, and had about 100 children, and started a luncheon club for elderly and people who was unemployed. And things were running really well, with the help of nobody else other than my own family.
After a new all-purpose community centre was built, the old centre was shut, but the Crees want the old building to reopen as it has more space and was, for many, the soul of the scheme.
28 years ago, I had my wedding reception in that hall. At the end of the day, the hall's got a lot of memories. And I think that's one of the reasons how the likes of the family's kept things going.
The whole family are trying to raise money to reopen the building, and Jim is constantly out collecting things to sell on.
The stuff that gets collected gets up to Blockhead Market. They have gave them the committee 2 days free to sell any stuff that they get. Normally get quite a lot of clothing, electrical, bric-a-brac. It's basically just mixed. But it's always things that sell.
The Crees have started a fundraising committee and have lots of local support, as the old community centre was widely used and is missed.
The weddings are really missing. You're even getting them coming chapping your door. When's the centre opening back up? So nearly all the community centres and everything shut down now.
So Wayne's kind of compete against Wayne's with different competitions and that. We had thousands of trophies up on the wall in the centre for dancing, dominoes, drafts, football, you name it.
There's nothing in the area for them today, like the younger ones. Neither there is. I mean, you think there's a lot of Wayne's about 12. You see them all walking about there smoking. But they're also taking hash. I mean, at 12 year old, we knew better not to take anything. Because my dad was really strict.
The old centre has been closed for months. And the Crees are worried it's deteriorating. So they're trying to arrange a look inside to assess what work needs to be done before they can get it open again. The police have been round to see Kay again after yet another incident.
Lisa got a phone call for her pal saying that her ex was doing at that house down there. And then she started fighting with the lassie and that's going to sell the a bottle. Split his head up. Then the police were here looking for her. And I just said enough. Says, no, I've ribbed out. Can't have all this at my door.
Hoffers!
I just feel I've got two wains I want to bring up, right? You know, with all the police at my door and phone out with my neighbours, all that. I just, nah. It's my house and I need to bring my two kids up.
Kids, mate? Wains! I'm not a wain hen.
So nobody's getting back in.
Chris is just coming up.
No, he's no.
Oh, yes.
Jenna's getting flung out tomorrow.
Sheila, she's 4 year with smack on it.
You're joking.
No.
Woo!
I can't. She asked me to leave because of an incident that took place on the Friday night. Me being drunk and still living down to Lassie's house just in the road for her and started fighting with Lassie down there. All because of Squigs. And then me and Squigs started fighting. And then my pal Laura put a bottle off the seat. Then we bolted because the police was coming and an ambulance for him. The lights down there. It was a good laugh and everything. I can see a point, it was getting too overcrowded anyway, you get what I mean?
Since Kay has put her foot down, Lisa is now living in a hostel while her mum looks after her little boy. Gordon didn't get the job he applied for. And there's other bad news. He's caught Kimberly lying to him. She had told him she was staying overnight with a friend, when actually she went camping with a big group, and she's now on strict nephew sitting duty.
I'm grounded for her. And Tom and Dad says different.
Her phone's come off her. She'll not be back on the computer. And she'll not be back out the door. But I phoned her dance teacher this morning. And told us she'll be back here dancing for a long time. No pals, no nothing. Till I think that she's ready to be trusted again.
I think because he went through everything he went through when he was younger. Because he didn't have a mum or dad. It makes him mad. Because he doesn't want to see us going out doing stuff like that.
It's not to him, he lies. No, anyway. Anything could have happened to them. And then, at the end of the day, it's the parents' fault for letting them camp out, although we didn't know they were camping out. So no day again, that's a certainty. I know that for a fact.
Marvin's court case has gone badly. And he's been locked up for 5 months, leaving Bullet in the house under the control of Dana, who is struggling to cope on her own.
I'm glad he's away. But other times, situations like this, I wish he was here. Just came where I'm coming from. But don't get me wrong, I'll always love him, even though he's hurt me and stuff like that. And don't know, he's wanting me to keep this house going so he gets a tag and I want my own house, to tell the truth. I want my own house. I don't like this street.
There is huge support in the scheme to reopen the old community centre, and the Crees have arranged a visit to check out how much work will need to be done to get things up and running again.
I feel better once we've been inside and seen what kind of state it's in. Hopefully, there's not been much needing done.
Getting their foot back in the door is a big deal.
Once we get inside, do you think we'll come back out? It's a sitting! No bother, they've just pooed things. They've just pooed the wood off.
Workmen have been in to turn radiators off.
So that could just be cut off. I'm trying to put a light on with the electric.
The inside of the centre is looking tired, and there are things that need to be done to repair some maintenance damage.
Let's jump the flame and see if it's going to collapse.
I think the crowd we've got, the quicker we can get in to get it done, the better.
Asking for 4 days to come in and paint it. Would there be a chance of us getting in here for 4 days to paint this place before we sign the lease? So it's all painted or just moving straight in?
We need to have the lease signed first.
So we sign the lease then? Yes. Right, that's fine.
Yeah.
Need to sign the lease first.
Mrs. Cree Sr. is feeling ill and can't make it for the look around the building.
I hope it's no long. Because due to ill health, I'm even over here. I miss it myself. And you're meeting different people. We're stuck in here, I'm meeting just my own family.
The council have offered the lease for £1 for the year, but want to make sure the residents have enough money in the bank to run it before they will let the centre reopen.
You can have the lease sitting, waiting, right, ready for you to have all your funding in place.
Mm-hmm. But we actually got a letter back from East Ayrshire Council. We put in for a grant, so hopefully they'll give us funding.
Right.
I mean, in the standard, it says East Ayrshire Council's doing everything they can to get us in. Rubbish.
Even with just £1 being offered as rent by the council, the residents feel they're not being supported in their mission to get the old scheme centre up and running again.
The group have to satisfy the council that they have the funding in place to meet all the legal requirements of taking on the lease of the building, which includes the running costs for electricity, gas, the proper insurance cover, third-party liability, contents insurance, etc., plus they hold responsibility for repairs and maintenance.
The Crees are desperate to get back into the old community centre, but the council are keen to make sure that the group really has enough money to take on the responsibility of running and maintaining the building before they hand over the keys. Fed up with all the trouble that she's ended up getting drawn into, Kay has put her foot down about having people in the house. She now wants to make a fresh start by selling up and moving on.
Yeah, it's a relief to get the house back to normal.
Mm. I'm moving.
Selling up and moving. Quite fancy co-winning, because Candace starts college there anyway.
No!
How, where do you want to go?
Chardonnay. The Chardonnay.
Alton Hall. The new houses?
Yes.
I don't want to move away from here.
I do.
That's only because you want to.
Not a new start.
But I don't.
Just fed up with all the shite stealing and all that. I just can't be bothered with it.
Kay may be planning to move the family for a fresh start, but Candace has good reason to stay put and is about to deliver some family news of her own. Gordon is running out of savings and fed up with not finding a new job. With one son in jail and golden girl Kimberly in the doghouse, Gordon has one thing on his mind.
I'm not really bothered about getting a job in out after I'm back my holidays, because I need to go on employment now. I mean, I've got a wee soldier to take. So I'll get a job when I come back. Hopefully. Just went away for you. A week's peace. Need phone. Turn the phone off. See a week in the sun. Wait for the carry ons and just go away and enjoy myself for a week.
Terrified of flying. The doctor's going to give me Valium as well. So I had to give me them last twice. I wasn't as bad 2 years ago on the plane. The first time, the year before, when I was ever on a plane, I was in an office too. Took a panic attack and everyone couldn't get a breath. I'll just get a couple of drinks in me this time before I go.
She's for 6 vodkas. She'll not go on the plane. She'll be drunk.
While Dana was looking after him, Bullet has escaped. Dana has heard that he's been run over and has gone to the vets to look for him.
Get knocked in by a car. Well, that's what somebody told me anyway.
Bullet is still alive, and Dana wants to take him home, even though his leg has been badly broken and he may need a major operation. The vets can't operate on Bullet until Dana pays part of the bill.
It's well too hard. There is pure greeting left in me. It's too hard. I need to take him in. No need to send me a bottle. No need to pay it up. I can't pay it for like £100 in a banner. But I need my dog back.
Back at the Crees, Anne has had a surprise in the mail.
Oh my God. An anonymous person has sent us a donation of £500. A cheque for £500. But we're really, really overwhelmed with you. I thought at first it was somebody who's lumped for £500 off me.
As well as donations, the Crees are raising money by collecting things to sell, charity bingo nights, coffee mornings and sponsored walks, and already have over £2,000 in the bank.
I reckon the stuff we've got just now, now at £80 anyway, hard to say because like everything else, the folk will try and bargain with you at the boot sale. I do it myself. We'll be sitting just over two and a half grand collected, plus what we're going to collect maybe within the next week or two.
Constantly raising money is hard work, and not always that pleasant.
Well, he asked us what the F we wanted. We told him. And he says, well, if I've got effing stuff, I'll be left to effing side for you. Come back to effing more tonight. Right, fine.
Round at Gordon and Annie's, they're about to leave for their first ever family holiday abroad. But Gordon is upset that he can't take everyone.
I've never been on holiday with any of the ones. I wish the rest of them would screw the knot and we could all go a family holiday. I would like everyone to be.
Gordon and Annie are going to Mallorca with their oldest daughter, Claire, 15-year-old Kimberly, and her friend. There's not enough money for 20-year-old Chris to come on holiday, and he isn't trusted to be left in the house on his own.
Oh my God, I wouldn't have a house. He would sell the full house. His pals would steal everything out of the house. They'd be what the cars generated every day. They'd have a great time. They'd be buying plenty of drinking, Charlie.
I didn't get any money to kill, so we just have to do what it usually does. Just jump from here, there and everywhere. I'm going on this holiday to try and forget all about worries, but I don't know. It's all about phoning them constantly to make sure they're all right.
Chris has been left sleeping till the last minute, and his only hope of cash is that the postman brings his social security gyro, or he'll be penniless as well as homeless for the coming week.
Because if the postman's not been in your harder...
Aye, that'll be fucking right.
I'm telling you that, that's right.
You should go and look for the postwoman and say to her, my mum and dad's going to live abroad and I need my gyro. And she'll choose to give us it.
I don't believe that's just to get it.
Everything packed. There's just time for Annie's nerve-calming vodkas.
I go, dig, 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 dig.
Sit still.
The post doesn't come, and Gordon and Annie leave Chris to fend for himself in the scheme while they're away. Chris is planning to stay at Kay's with Candice, who's just told her mum that she's pregnant.
I don't know what to do, really, because of what folk are saying to me. I'm only 16 and all that. But I want to keep it myself. I don't believe in abortions. I don't know if I could go through with it.
What do you mean?
If I could go through with getting an abortion and getting rid of it. Like killing it, basically. My mum says she's flinging me out if I keep it. Chrissy asked his mum and dad if we could move in there. He wants me to keep it, so he does. I want to keep it. I've just kind of tried to get me to get rid of it.
Oh, I can't be fucked up about it, man. I've been back asleep.
That's a good thing, innit? There's no way to talk about it.
16-year-old Candice is thinking about giving up on her college course and getting a house in the scheme with Chris. The Crees fundraising may have been going great guns, but the family have been rocked by the news that Mrs. Cree Sr. has got cancer and has to go for a series of tests.
I wanted to send an ambulance today, kid, but Marion's going to take her out in the car.
I wasn't going in an ambulance.
I think as it came nearer to the time for her to go, she was getting really agitated. Might be able to do something. Ken, they can't operate on her, but they maybe be able to give her chemotherapy or something. Just need to wait and see. Nothing else we can really do.
Kay is moving house, and she's told Candice that she will pay for a private let for Candice and Chris to set up home, but only if Candice doesn't have the baby.
I feel terrible. My lassie's pregnant and she's 16. I feel it's my fault because I let Chrissy stay here. But I thought she would have been more careful. I don't want her to have it. She's only 16. She's just started college. And I just feel it's hard, and she doesn't know how hard it is. She thinks it's easy, having a wane.
At the Crees, there's been more bad news.
Tell me it was in the uterus, the pelvis, the bones, and it spread up to her ribs, on the ribs. And I asked him about her breathing because it was like quite laboured. I thought it was her asthma. And they says, no, that's the illness taking its toll.
She gets in on Thursday for chemotherapy. It's just an overnight stay and she gets back out on Friday. But she's probably a wee bit tired in that when she gets out. We'll just have to wait and see.
Makes you wonder. That's everybody in my family. Anybody that's died, it's cancer. So that's...
We just want to see her getting back up on her feet. Because it's just no like her, she's on the go. Hopefully we can get the centre up and running quick and get her round there, get her out for a wee while, instead of sitting watching the four boys.
Because Marvin is in jail, Dana is responsible for Bullet, who needs an operation. Unfortunately, she's still struggling to find the money to pay for it.
They would need at least £100. But at the end of the day, all the family should be chipping in. For the money, not just me. But it's not my fault. The dog runs away. I just feel as if everybody's like depending on Dana will pay it, but it's just not like that. They can't keep my dog off me. Once he's better, they can't keep him off me. I hope they can't keep him off me.
After more fighting in the scheme, Dana decides to give up Marvin's house and move on. Bullet is left unclaimed at the vet's, still waiting for an expensive operation. Mrs. Cree Sr. has managed to get through her first chemotherapy session for her cancer.
So I'm tired today. I never slept last night.
Oh, she's fine. The wig's nice.
It's good.
My sister's come in, the other two sisters come in and thought she'd had her hair done. Because it's the very same colour. I think she's feeling a wee bit better now. She had a wee bit better colour on her face today, mind you.
Definitely.
So.
A month after he was left at the vet's needing a major operation, Bullet's fate has been decided.
I think he's been treated very well. Yeah. Normally, if dogs haven't been treated well, they'll see some sort of behavioural problem. Either they'll be scared if you go to them, or might be aggressive if you go to him. He's great. He's obviously been well loved, yeah. No problem to work with. Even when we're putting bandages on things, he's absolutely smashing. And he's pretty good with other dogs as well. He's just really nice. A bit space for a dog at home, we would take him home. He's that nice.
Really?
He is, he's really nice. Dogs Trust have been kind enough to take him. So he will go to a rehoming centre and hopefully somebody will come along, fall in love with him and take him.
Since he was rescued, Bullet has now been successfully rehomed. Next week on the scheme, Gordon and Annie get back from holiday to be faced with every parent's worst nightmare.
We've just told him that we want to help him, just to admit the truth, that he has taken it.
Don't listen to my mum, she's well up your shite.
Kay disowns Candace.
Oh my God, pure hater, man.
The Cree's fight starts to get serious.
I asked you one thing. How do you think it went? I waste of fucking time.
And another family is ripped apart by drugs.
I can hear that. You can't remember now.
For legal reasons not connected with anyone who's appeared in the series to date, transmission of the final two episodes of the scheme will now be subject to a delay. They'll be rescheduled for broadcast at a later date.